Thanks. Again, we're back in Building 220, like Josh said, at the Autonomous Mission Operations Test. And this time we're talking with Alvin Drew, who is the commander for today's run of the test. So thanks so much for coming back. I know we talked with you last time we had these tests going on back in May. So
yes.
This is a little different, though. I think last time y'all were using just basic what we already know to deal
yes.
with the time delay. And this time you're trying out some new tools and procedures, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. How's it going?
It's going well. It's like you talked about before, the tools we were using last time were the same 20th century tools we've been using since the days of Mercury, so they're 50 years old. It's like called the walkie-talkie model of talking, where you know, you key the mic and you say something and you let go of the mic and the person keys the mic on the other end and they talk to you, and it may work well if you are doing something fairly simple and you're only a few hundred miles away from the Earth,
mm-hmm.
But the distances we're simulating right now, it doesn't work as well. So with this, today we've got all our 21st century tools that some people recognize as being just normal stuff we use, like texting and things like that, to see if that helps us out any.
You wouldn't think NASA needed any help getting into the 21st century, but I guess we have stuff that has worked for a while, but it's time to move on to some new.
We've got new challenges in front of us and new things to do. So the tools that worked well for the past 50 years, why fool with them? And they,
mm-hmm.
they're working fine. These are things we know that those tools will not work when we are long distance away from the Earth. We're at the speed of light. You know, it may take you 20 minutes to get an answer back.
Mm-hmm.
And if that answer was, can you say all that again? Well, that gets me very frustrating. So it's nice having that written records of what you wanted,
right.
So you can send a text message so they can just reread the message.
Well, how do you think that's going so far? Do you like the tools?
I think it's going great. It's a little bit strange because I'm used to lots of chatter over the radios when things are going on. And spent the whole morning, I think we talked to them three times. And so you think we're mad at each other or something. We're not. It's just there's still lots of just this typing and chattering away. So
mm-hmm.
if you're a teenager with a phone, it would seem perfectly normal to you. But to somebody like me who's just a few months away from an AARP card, it's a little bit weird to
mm-hmm.
not hear any chatter over the radio lines.
So how many, there are three runs in all that you'll do today
yes.
at three different time delays.
Yes.
5 seconds.
5 seconds,
50 seconds,
50 seconds and 300 seconds, which is 5 minutes.
Right. So
yes.
Which ones have you done so far?
So far we've done 50 seconds and we'll look at 5 minutes, and then we'll do another run actually with 50 seconds again. We won't do the 5 second delay.
Mm-hmm. What kind of things have you had to do under those delays? What kind of tasks and activities?
Basically, I call it this old hab. Things are broken. I guess we're on our way home. So we've got computers that hard drives that are failing. We've got inspections. We've got some dings on our spacecraft from micrometeoroid strikes. We've got an exercise device that's gotten worn out from, I guess, we've been doing too much exercise. That's a good thing, I take it.
Good job.
So things were just tidying things up and getting ready for the trip back home.
And is it hard to do it without being able to talk instantly to the ground, or do you think you're able to handle it?
As long as things run normally, there's not a lot of reason to talk to the ground. It's just coordination. It's mm-hmm. letting them know we're starting this procedure on this time, and they want to know that. And how do things go when you get done with it? You know, we found this particular thing. We put this away over here. We tested this thing. We got this piece of data back. And so none of it's really urgent, and doesn't need to be a whole lot of interaction. Because if we send them information, they get it, they acknowledge it. If they have any questions, they bring them back up. So I haven't really noticed any big to-dos. I think when things get dynamic, when you maybe something goes wrong,
mm-hmm.
Which I suspect will happen here in the next couple of runs, that's when the adrenaline starts to pick up a bit, because there's time delays on both ends now.
Right, okay. Well, so, you know, going through this now, do you think this is going to get us ready for when it is time to go to an asteroid? You know, we've got the Orion and the Space Launch System being built now to help get us in that direction, but we're going to be ready once we get there?
I think so. We're making big strides right now, and what I'm seeing a lot of feedback from crew members is that these are tools we can use right now on board the International Space Station, whereas the tools we have right now work fine. These actually make our life better up there. Having things like text so we don't have to go, could you please say again, even though there's no time delay,
mm-hmm.
They can go look at the message. So why not? It's not a big leap into these particular technologies. They're things that work on the same computers that we use on the space station right now. So we're actually looking at implementing some of these things here and now. Some of the displays we have over here, if you look at our iPads, this is how we interact with this particular model of a spacecraft. It wouldn't be a big deal to make that work on board our space station. So if you're looking at a procedure, you want to look at a systems, you don't have to float over to a workstation, look at it, and float back over to your work site.
Mm-hmm.
You can take everything with you and use it right then and there. Well, now we've got iPads or tablets available on board the space station. We can put the software on those particular tablets and have that capability.
Mm-hmm.
So there are things that can enhance our lives on the space station now, and of course get us ready for going further and further away, either right into out beyond the moon and even further out interplanetary space in the coming years.
Getting easier to imagine then?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you so much for talking with us again. We really appreciate it. Sounds like you've got a lot of interesting stuff going on here.
Yes. Looking forward to seeing more of it.